up, guys? We are back with Pokemon Emerald. This is where we left off. We are in the Petalburg's woods. Did I say that right? Oh, well. Anyway, I was originally going to use Talo as my flying Pokemon, but I just remembered something very important about Talo. I'll go more into detail about that later on. There's a lot of bugs here, so Torchic can pretty much level up pretty fast here. I also was originally going to use... I think there's a hidden item right here in this and that little square in the middle right there. I'm pretty sure there's a hidden item there. Wurmple, Wurmple, Wurmple. Mei does use a Wurmple in anime, does she, and evolves to Beautifly. But I don't like Beautifly that much, so just die. Beautifly is really not that good, I don't think. Hell, Butterfree is much better than Beautifly because of its special ability. Anyway, I think there's an item right here. You got a potion, that's it? Okay. Let's go down here first for a continue. Go down here and get this item right here. We found a Pokeball! Wow! Okay. Are you a trainer? You're a thief, you try to steal my someone's Pokemon. Oh, you're a thief, you try to steal someone's Pokemon, but we're going to be doing a lot of that in Pokemon Coliseum or something. Okay. What was I saying? Oh, yeah. Now, you may have noticed in my Pokemon Yellow LP, I use pretty much nothing but Pokeballs to catch Pokemon, but I'm not going to be doing that in Pokemon Emerald because Game Freak realized how easy it was to catch Pokemon Pokeballs, so they made that much more difficult to do in later generations. For example, if I use a Pokeball on a legendary Pokemon when they're at sleep and have one hit point left, I probably have like a 5% chance to catch them at best. Alright, I've got a bunch of Pokemon. Battle me. They're all bug types. 1, 2, 3, 4. And since they're all bug types, I can just finish them off with one Ember. So there's no point in showing this battle. Let's move on, shall we? Speaking of Mei's Wurmple in the anime, yes, just like the anime, when you catch a Wurmple, it'll either evolve into a what are those two Pokemon called again? Silcoon or a Cascoon. I don't know exactly what determines that, but yeah, if for some reason you want to use a Beautifly or Dustox, you might want to catch it at a Wurmple, and because it evolves to level 7, but. The only problem that is, I don't think it's possible to tell whether or not it's gonna evolve to a Cascoon or a Silcoon. All right, this guy here is missing his Shroomish or something like that. I think, yeah, Team Aqua. If you're playing Pokemon Sapphire, this will be Team Aqua. If you're playing Pokemon Ruby, it'll be Team Magma, of course. We're playing Pokemon Emerald. We're gonna be fighting both Team Aqua and Team Magma here, which is kind of interesting. I like that. You fight them both at the same time. You fight Maxi twice, I believe, and you fight Archie one time towards the end of the game or something like that. I don't know. And you're going to fight a lot of Poochyenas, which is a good thing because Poochyenas give off a attack IV, I believe, attack EV. And that's always a welcome addition on Blaziken. Alright. Die, Poochyena. You're kidding me. You're tough. Yes, you got beat by a little kid. I still never understood how an evil organization like this runs off because a kid beat up their Pokemon or something. I don't know. So for saving your ass, you're gonna give me a Great Ball, seriously? I guess I'll take that as a thanks. Okay. Where did you go that quick? I told you, I love it how that happens. I love how they just disappear like that. That's so awesome. That's, wow. They got super speed. Like that Dragon Ball Z super speed and stuff. Whatever. Alright, Shroomish. I remember what I was going to say now. It's a rare encounter, but this is the only place in the game, I believe. If I'm wrong, please correct me. But you can catch a... what do you mean you didn't die? You can get a Slack off here. Slacking is actually a very, very good Pokemon for those of you who realize it or not. Even though it has its Trump ability, Slacking's job is to KO something in one hit. You would normally use a Hyper Beam on Slacking, but the thing is, if you use Hyper Beam on Slacking, you can't switch. And that'll give your opponent time to set up on you. Return is strong, but you know, if you're fighting AI opponents, then you can use Hyper Beam. But if you're fighting human opponents, then don't use Hyper Beam. I am indeed going to catch a slack off, but I'm not going to use it on doing this LP. I'm not going to use it until the until I do the Pokemon Coliseum Coliseum battles. I do use Slack in Pokemon Coliseum because those bastards is just hard. Because unfortunately, the Pokemon in Pokemon Coliseum are perfectly effort value trained, which just isn't fair. The damn Latios has 31 EVs all the way across. And it has Soul Dew on. And what the fuck happened? I had a recording error there of some sort. Oh, whatever. That happens a lot when I'm using this old device. I told you, I can't use my new device because my new device has like a horrible lag and I have to find out why it's happening. Actually, I think that only happens on my PS2. It doesn't seem to happen on my GameCube controller or whatever. Wappa, 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 worm! Burn in hell, Wurmple! Alright, I think that's enough time here in the Petersburg Woods. Let me just edit the rest out until I get that Pokemon. Damn, what took you so long to come out? Jesus Christ. Well, at least it's a female, so I can breed it and catch more. Anyway, I'm not going to use this Pokemon in the... I've only got 3 Pokeballs, damn. If I hit it, I'll probably knock it out. I'm not going to use this Pokemon in the main game because, unfortunately, Slaking is one of those Pokemon that takes forever, and I mean forever, to level up in the main game. Stay in the Pokeball. Good. Slaking was caught. Slack off the Slacker Pokemon. Give it to a nickname? No. Give it a nickname? That's okay. Alright, what we got here? Slackoff is a calm nature. We're definitely going to have to be rebreeding that to get some better natures and stuff like that. Now, remember what I said in my Final Fantasy LPs, how I realized that nothing is random in video games, especially RPGs? I mean, some games, things are random, but in RPG games, pretty much nothing is random. Some of you may be aware of this, some of you may not, but in Pokemon Emerald, there's actually a fixed way to get shiny Pokemon. You can get it by breeding or you can get it by wild Pokemon. Unfortunately, TM number 9, that's a bullet seed, right? Unfortunately, in order to do that, you need to have access to your secret ID number. Your secret ID number is different from your regular ID number up there. 13878. That's your train ID number. It's your secret ID is different than that. Your secret ID number determines the IVs of wild Pokemon and your and when you find a shiny Pokemon, stuff like that. So everything happens when it's supposed to. So in other words, if you happen to encounter a random Pokemon around a certain time when you turn on the game, that Pokemon will be shiny. It's kind of hard to explain. I'll be here all day explaining how that works, but there definitely is a fixed way to get shiny Pokemon in this game. And if I ever find out what my secret ID is, I will indeed be showing you that. Especially since I have a camcorder. I can show you the how to do that. But the only way I can find out my secret ID is to I'm gonna have to take one of my Pokemon and trade it over to like Diamond or Pearl and use a action replay code on that Pokemon to figure out what my train ID, what my hidden ID was for this game. Which is kind of cheating, but yeah. Now I know what you're thinking. He's gonna use his code to get a shiny Vulpix. Wrong. The reason why I'm not going to do that is because, unfortunately, using this method, all shiny Pokemon are males. And of course, you know that I named my Vulpix Lococo, and Lococo is indeed a female. So we're not going to be doing that. We got a potion. Okay. Anything else hitting up here? Usually in little batches like this, you'll find a hidden item, like so. So let's just Come on now. Wingull. You know what? Pelipper is actually a excellent, and I mean a excellent HM slave. Pelipper learns fly, surf, waterfall, and another move, I think. It's actually one of the best HM slaves in Diamond or Pearl because it also learns defog, too. So, yes, when I LP Diamond or Pearl, I'm most likely going to use Pelipper as my one of my HM slaves. I'm going to main 4 Pokemon and have 2 HM slaves, like I normally do things. Yes, when I normally play my Pokemon games, I normally main 4 Pokemon and have 2 HM slaves. That's just the way I do things. Defense Curl. Normally I'll use Starmie, but Starmie also takes a long time to level up. I need to use a water Pokemon that levels up really, really, really fast. And that Pokemon is Milotic. Unfortunately, that thing's very, very difficult to catch, of course. And it's even more aggravating to evolve it to Milotic. As some of you will notice by now. But let's get on with it. This guy's a wrist trainer, I believe. Alexander Chen, I have a lot of money. Yes, he's just like that Cindy trainer last episode. Like every time you beat him, you get like a lot of money for that point of game and stuff. Zigzagoon. I should be able to knock it out with one Ember here. But I've only got 14 left, so I need to get out of here. Tail Whip. How did you not die from that? What? Oh yeah, I forgot. Those guys do have four stars, don't they? Could've get hit. He wasted it. Died. I forgot those guys do have four stores. Well, I guess he got a lot of money, so that's how you can, why couldn't I win? Okay, we got a little kid with a lot of money, but at the same time, we got evil organizations out here like Team Aqua, and why are you out here by yourself with all that money when you got these bad guys? They can just come in and take your shit. I mean, seriously. Anyway, this is our last, I believe. You can see me from way over here. The lesses are hot in this game, but they're even hotter in Fire Red Leaf Green, especially with their little pose with it. Their pose in Fire Red Leaf Green is kind of sexy. I'm such a fucking pervert sometimes. All right, I'm running out of embers. Need to save those because I think I got a lot of more training battles before I get to the next town. This won't be a problem if I get another level because it'll evolve to a Kabuskin pretty soon. Lotad and Shroomish. I think Shroomish and Lotad are exclusive to like Ruby or Sapphire, depending on which version you're playing. I'm not sure how that works. I forgot about it. But I don't use either one of them, so I really don't care. Even though Ludicolo is a very good Pokemon. And of course, Shroomish evolves to that Pokemon that does the infamous sub punch thing. Alright, we are twins. We battle Pokemon together. I don't think you can fight these guys until you actually have 2 Pokemon. Alright, the introduction of double battles. The third generation, Gina and me. What's the battle? Me or whatever. Seedot and Lotad. Oh, it's these 2 Pokemon. Yeah, Seedot and Lotad are exclusive to whichever version you're playing, Ruby and Sapphire. I think they're both for Emma. I'm not sure how that works, but oh well. Anyway, Seedot and Lotad. Double battles works just like single battles. Only thing is, it can be kind of cheap because you can do all kind of cheap combinations. Like you can focus on one specific Pokemon and stuff like that, and you can do like Earthquake and Explosion. It's just, you know what? I realize that a lot of people don't like double battles because of all the cheap things that you can do. Because most double battle teams use things like Sunny Day and Rain Dance and Explosion. And that's pretty much it, really. Trick Room. Most double battle teams just use cheap double battle strategies, and it gets really, really old, and nobody likes double battles. But I kind of like double battles. They're pretty fun. All right, let's see here. Slack Up's loafing around. Good night.
Oh, excuse me.
That's another good thing about Slack Off, that it actually has a sleep move, even though it has a way of trying to using it, but still kind of reliable. Right? Die! We battled together, but we both lost. By the way, one of the gym leader battles is a double battle, by the way. It's been slightly changed in Emerald than it was in Ruby and Sapphire. I've got a piece of cooking. Give me 1 minute, please. Anyway, let's move this right along. There's a fisherman here. You probably got a bunch of magic cards, right? Yeah. Alright, cherry berries. Once again, you can grow berries here. I don't think I want to do that in this game. I don't know. What you got, Granny? Chestnut berry. Very, very good berry there. Wakes you up when you sleep. Might want to say that for emergency or whatever. Huh? Don't you know me? You got magic cards, right? Of course you got magic card. Magic card, carp, 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 carp. I'm not going to show a battle with a bunch of magic cards. There's just no point. But keep in mind that magic cards do give off a speedy EV, so it's not completely useless. Let's go up here first. Let me see. X the fan. Alright, we are in Rustboro City, but we're going to go back to this route first. And now we're back to Rustboro City. Okay. Why did you put that there? Why did you put that way over there with that fist there? That makes no sense. Okay. I think there's a lot of important things that we have to do here before going to the gym leader. But first, I'm going to go to the Pokemon Center and heal up. Alrighty, with that out of the way, let's go in here first. I think there's something here that I want to get. Let me see. It's my biggest... Can you catch a Pikachu in this game? I can't remember. I think you can somewhere. I forgot. Pikachu is such a popular Pokemon that you should be able to catch it pretty much any game except for the except for Black and White, of course. Yes, this is where I want to go. The typical school. Students who don't study get a little get a taste of my Quick Claw. Quick Claw, okay. Quick Claw, yes. Quick Claw. I forgot about that. This item is considered cheap in on Smogon sometimes because it's a hex. A lot of people use a Quick Claw on slow Pokemon that has a lot of attack power. For example, you might be going up against a Rhydon. Normally, you get the first attack as a Rhydon, but the thing is, Rhydons carry Quick Claws and hits you with Earthquake and you're in trouble. Some people consider that just cheap because it was a hex. It wasn't, you know, that's not something that's supposed to be happening or whatever. What we got here? ATM number one! We know what that is. It's cut, of course. All starter Pokemon can learn cut conveniently. But I don't think I'm going to be teaching that to Torchic. Let's move up here. Anyway, since I don't have my Kabuskin yet, I'm going to do a little traveling. Let me just go here now. Do a few channel battles until I get my Kabuskin. And then we're going to take care of Roxanne. Level 16 for Torchic and it's trying to learn Peck, which is I'm going to replace Growl with Focus Energy with it. Gives it a little tiny flying move. What this does is it enables me to do super effective hits on bug types and grass types when I don't want to use my my Ember attack. Like so. Not very strong, apparently. Ember would have knocked it out, but that's okay. I can use this 35 times. Alright. What? Torchic is evolving! Hey, don't forget, you can always press the B button if you want to stop evolution for whatever reason. Only reason why you do this is to learn certain moves faster. Congratulations, your Torchic evolved to Kabuskin! Make absolutely sure that you don't over-level torch it, because you might be fighting like four Pokemon in a training battle. It'll be at level 16, and then it'll be at level 17 at the end of that battle. It'll evolve to Combusken at level 17, but it won't learn Double Kick. It has to evolve at level 16 to learn Double Kick. Just keep that in mind. And you definitely want to use this move if you don't have another Grass type or Water type or whatever. You definitely want this. Trust me. Combusken learned Double Kick. The thing I love about Double Kick is that it can break through subs. Double Kick is a nice little fighting move. It has attack power of 30, but it attacks twice. So basically, it has attack power of 60. When you add stat to that, it's 90. So yes, really good fighting move here. It's better than some people think it is. We found a Repel. All right, I'm gonna be using those a lot since I'm gonna be using Pokemon that level up pretty damn fast. Whisper. Now that I got my super strong Combusken, let's go to the Rustboro City Gym. Let me save my game before doing that in case that damn Rotom gets a critical hit. Anyway, let's see if we can do this. Let me go in here first. What do you want? My Pokemon evolved. He has a lot of HP now. He should be a super potion. Oh yeah, that's just another way of teaching you a basic stuff here for those who are new to Pokemon. Super potions are just expensive, man. Look at that. See here. I'm gonna buy some more Pokeballs. Another thing that I think they started doing in this generation, if they started doing this in Gold and Silver, please let me know. I can't remember. But when you buy an item, it'll let you know on the left how many you have in your bag already. See that? That way you won't have to waste your money. So I've got 4 posters and 1 super potion, so I really don't need to buy any more items. So. I'll be fine. I'll be A-okay. Anyway, let's go to our first gym battle. Alright, you can avoid that trainer, and you can avoid this trainer, and you can avoid this guy if you want to, but we're not going to be doing that, because we can't level up that way now, can we? Do, 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 do. Let me guess, this is a rock gym, right? Okay. Which is precisely why you need to evolve Torchic into Combusken before coming here. Otherwise, you're going to be in some serious trouble. Die! Naturally, if you started out with a Treecko or a Mudkip, you'd be fine. But I don't think Treecko actually learns any grass moves. I think it learns Drain, but you can teach it a Bullet Seed, I think. Did I even get Bullet Seed? I can't remember. One thing I don't understand about Geodudes is why the hell does Geodude learn Mud Sport? Of course, it's a ground-type Pokemon and it's always in the mud, but the thing is, Mud Sport lowers the attack power of electric moves, but Geodude's immune to electricity, so why did I do that? Why did they even bother giving him... See that? Why did they even bother giving Geodude a Mud Sport when you are not going to use electric on this thing? Especially since you can't catch electric types yet. Can you? Oh well. Geodude. Nothing here but Geodudes. I hate Geodudes. They're so common. Very aggravating. And they give off defensive IVs, which is something I don't usually get. Okay. Alright, we got that out the way. Moving on to the gym leader. And before every gym leader battle, you do want to save the game in case something happens. And Roxanne is pretty cute, by the way. Hello, I'm Roxanne, the Rustboro City Gym Leader. Okay. I became a gym leader so that I might apply to what I learned at the Pokemon Training School in battle. Okay. sometimes I'm really not good at reading these things. Would you kind of demonstrate how to battle and with which Pokemon? Leader Roxanne would like to battle, and Roxanne is pretty sexy. I like Roxanne. All right, let's move it on. Geodude, of course. Double kick on Geodude. And he's dead. Okay. Dang, next! Oh, she got two Geodudes. I thought she had one. Or maybe I'm thinking of a Brock or something. I don't know. But this one isn't going to do any better than the last one did. Okay. Die! Next! Her trump card! Pokemon is Nose Pass! Nose Pass has an evolution in Diamond and Pearl, I think. Or was that Black and White? I can't remember. I think it was Diamond and Pearl when he got evolution. This thing's pretty bulky, surprisingly. It can take one of my double kicks and fight back with a rock tomb. Block. It's blocking me. Okay. Prevent me from running away. She's going to use a Orange Berry, which screws this up for you because AI is pretty dumb. Oh, never mind. Use the potion anyway. I didn't think she should be using the potion because the health wasn't low enough, but oh well. This Nose Pass does have a Rock Tomb, which is a rock attack that lowers your speed. So, like I said, if you're not using a double kick, then you're going to be in big trouble. Just die already, please. Thank you. $300 spear points. We defeated our first gym leader. It seems that I have much more to learn. I understand. The Pokemon rules state that trainers will be given this badge if they defeat the gym leader. Please set this for the League Stone Badge or whatever. 1500 money. The Stone Badge, our first badge. And I like how in Pokemon Black and White, they actually show you a picture of the badge when you get it and stuff. That's pretty cool. With this, we can use Cut, and she's going to give us TM number 39, which is naturally a Rock Attack. This is going to be a Rock Tomb, I believe. And not only for its damage, but it lowers the speed 100% of the time. TMs can only be used one time. They realized that this was very aggravating, so they fixed that in Black and White. In Black and White, TMs can be used as many times as you wish. Unfortunately, if you want to buy a team, it's going to empty your pocket. Alright, I think Combusken can actually learn this move. I'm not sure. No, not Bullet Seed. Let me see that. Yeah. So, Combusken can actually learn a nice Rock Attack. Which is good, which is okay for the main game because Combusken is a flying type, so you can use it to fight off those Swellos and stuff. Well, looks like Team Michael is at it again, but we'll deal with them on this episode, so we'll see you guys later. Take it easy.